In this video, we're going to cover the Splay's events page, first introduced in Splay release version 1.4.0. So firstly, what is an event? An event is any single incident where control information is sent out of the Splay, typically to trigger an external device. To make the Splay as compatible as possible, we've implemented a huge range of protocols. So let's dive in. But to create a new event, we're going to go to the plus icon next to the search bar. This will allow us to enter the event name and define the output type. So here you can see OSC is selected by default. Now this is Open Sound Control, and this is used for networking sound synthesizers, computers, and other media devices for purposes such as musical performance or show control. The advantages of OSC are its flexibility, interoperability, and accuracy. As you can see here, we can either broadcast or we can unicast by defining an IP address. We can set a port number, here I'm going to set 3000, and we can set an address for the stream. So I'm going to put /go. We can also define the type. So we've got integer, float, or string. And then finally, we can define the argument. Next, we've got RS232. Now this is sent from the Splay's rear DB9 port at 9600 baud. This uses 8-bit data, 1 stop bit, and no flow control. Now RS232 has been around since the 60s. It's a rock solid standard for sending low bandwidth control signals point to point. In our industry, it's often found on the rear of projectors, AV switches, or for other uses where you want to trigger different states. So to define an RS232 event, you select the RS2 event type, you give it a name, and then you define the command in the box. If you want to add a line feed, simply add /L at the end, or /R for a carriage return. Next, we've got relays. The Splay features two relays on its rear, each rated up to 60 watts with 2 amp throughput. These can be used for low power devices or for connecting to contactors to control high current loads, such as motors, pumps, or to even control mains power to your lighting control system to shut everything down out of hours and save you money on power bills. The Splay gives you access to normally open and normally closed ports. You can connect to these using convenient pluggable rising clamp connectors on the rear of the device. When a relay event is triggered, the relays hold their state until another event changes them, or the Splay is power cycled. Next we have UDP, which stands for User Datagram Protocol. The Splay allows us to define an IP, a port, and then a command to send. Here I'm going to set the port as 6000, and the command as something basic like OX00. UDP is a low latency network protocol commonly used in building automation and management, alongside AV and control systems, and digital signage players. Finally, we have ArtNet, Streaming ACN, and Physical DMX out of the Splay's rear ports. These type of events allow for single frames to be sent with high priority. If we go onto ArtNet, we can see we can define either a broadcast or unicast. We can set the ArtNet universe, the channel, and then the channel level. These event types all allow single frames to be sent with the highest priority. If you did want to define a sequence of frames, we recommend creating a queue and adding it to a playlist. So we've spoken about event types and a few use cases. Next, we're going to cover how to use them on the Splay. As you may have seen, each event is listed on the left-hand side of the page. We can select, edit, and send them all within this window to aid troubleshooting and speed up your installation. If you're sending UDP, OSC, ArtNet, or Streaming ACN to a computer and you're not receiving data, it's worth checking your computer's firewall settings to ensure network packets entering your computer are not being blocked. For the Splay to send an event, it must be used as part of a playlist. In this example, I'm going to create a playlist to power on an installation using contactors through a relay event, then set the default state on digital signage screen, and then use a special loopback command on IP address 127.001 to send an OSC event to the Splay's API to begin the default lighting state. You can find a link to the OSC API along with the HTTP API down in the video's description. So we'll navigate to playlists. So here we can see the ambient lighting state, and we've got some evening lighting effects too. So what I'm going to do is create a playlist by typing in a name. I'm going to call this Startup. Now we're going to navigate to events. and we're going to pull out our contactor and put this on the event track. Next, we'll put that loopback trigger in, our ambient lighting state, and we'll drop in our media slot. And we'll press save. Now we can see when this is played, the relay is triggered, and the lighting state starts playing back. This can be set to happen on a daily basis by using the scheduler. I'll navigate to the page now. We'll call this daily power up. We'll select the startup playlist. We'll say this will happen infinitely at 6 a.m. There we go, and now that's going to happen every day. We can do the same again to create one to power off. Another interesting thing we can do is create an interface. Let's say someone arrives early, they want to turn the system on sooner, or they want to close down and power up the entire system midway through the day. So to do this, we're going to create a management interface. Press the plus button, and we're going to call this management. And I'm going to save that. This power up, this interface can be presented to any user of the installation to power up the system. You could also use the S-Play's inbuilt GPIO triggers to fire off this playlist. For example, you could wire up a button allowing a staff member to press it at the beginning of the day to make sure the entire system powers up as expected. I hope this video has given a good introduction to the type of things you can achieve with events. If you've got any questions, any feature requests, definitely let us know in the comments or get in touch with our team. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next one.